Round of the women's under 48 kilo class, the bantamweight, 7.5 stone in old money. Next match on mat two is between the Cuban, there she is, Yannette Bemoy, in the blue, and she'll be up against the feisty Russian, Lyudmila Bogdanova. Has a real attitude, this 25-year-old, the blonde-haired from Russian, fifth in this year's European Championships in Lisbon, but this is her Olympic debut, into the second round to face a very strong Cuban. Bemoy, the world champion silver medalist in Rio last year, lost to Ryoko Tani. Tani, by the way, who on the other mat, on mat one, has gone through to the third round. She won a real tussle against Wu Shugung, the 20-year-old from China. Won on a golden score. We'll perhaps have a word from Nicola on her performance in a moment. But meantime, let's watch what's happening live in front of us on mat two. Bemoy in the blue, Bogdanova in the white.
Bemoy starting off already with the combinations that she does, the drop Sianagi throw to the front and the leg grabs to the back. Right-handed player, very explosive.
She was actually the world champion 3 years ago. She took advantage of Tani's absence when Tani was giving birth. Bemoy, the world champion in Cairo. As we were talking a little earlier, from that fabulous Cuban school, so strong, particularly in the women's division. It's unlikely we're going to have too much of a break in any of these fights, but we will reflect on Tani going through to the third round shortly. Next breakdown, we'll get Nicola's thoughts on a terrific tussle with Wu Shugung, but the star of this particular day, and perhaps for the whole tournament, trying to win her third gold medal in a row, is doing well so far. The first point of the match, a minor score, a penalty, goes against Bogdanova. Just needs to work a little harder, so Bemoy ahead by Akoka.
Now, the Cuban fighters are very good at doing this. They fight a slow-paced contest until they actually explode into an attack. And it's very, very dangerous to actually go on towards the Cuban fighters, because they take you one way. If you pull back, they take you the other way with a leg grab. And it's a matter of trying to disturb their balance. You see Bemoy just waiting there quite patiently, and as soon as she gets a grip, she'll bang in a strong attack.
This sport is about lots and lots of things, but balance is up there. Without it, you can't do much. With it, you've got a very stable platform from which to work. A word about Tani.
Yeah, no, fantastic. I've seen Wu and Tani fight before, and it went to golden score before, and it's just done that again. Went the full duration of the match, and then Tani just managed to score a Yuko with a Koso Tagaki, a leg technique, you know, in the golden score after about a minute in the golden score period. So just got through it, just got through the fight. It's quite something, I'd say, to take Tani to a golden score.
Midway through this second round fight in the women's under 48, the bantamweights. Chair umpire again having to take evasive action. No time for a quick kip on those chairs. You might get a mouthful of judo player if you're not careful. Bogdanova skipping off the mat, taking evasive action. Saw her in Lisbon. Oh, she's...
did well to get off
really
that Sianagi.
Twisted away. Yeah, I saw her in Lisbon at the European Championships, and attitude is not her problem.
Yeah,
she, I think she takes no for an answer very often. She will be furious with this. She's had another penalty score against her, again for passivity, is that, and that means that the Coco is upgraded to the Yuko.
Yeah, and so Bogdanova has got to start putting in the work, otherwise she's going to get penalised again. She looks a physically strong player, but basically the Cuban's not letting her settle. And she's got the grip over the top, and an attempt on Uchimata. coach telling the Russian to switch it. Shumata and switch it backwards. Let's see what she does. Bomoy going for the strangle. She circled this round. I don't think she's got the net caught. She's still going for it. She's circling round. She's got the leg trapped. Bogdanova rolls it out of the area. Once the fight goes out of that square, whatever's happening on the ground, Mate's called and the fighters will come back to the spot.
Plenty of expectation from the island of Cuba going into this event, but a big blow for them and a major embarrassment as we look at one of their great personalities, the coach, Ronaldo Vaisha. Real blow when one of their top players, Yuricel Laborde, perhaps their top player, double world champion, favourite for gold in the 78 kilos class, claimed political asylum in the USA, so she isn't here.
I've heard that apparently she's working in a McDonald's. So there you go, instead of fighting at Olympic Games.
Get a Happy Meal.
McDonald's. Yeah.
Happy Meal or gold medal, let me have a think about that. Yuricel Laborde isn't here, but Yannette Bomoy certainly is. Fairly Spartan training conditions in Cuba, but whatever they do it without running hot water, but it certainly works for them.
It's tough over there. They don't seem to have much money. The dojo's an old training hall. There's one creaky little fan that turns around once every minute to give you a little bit of air conditioning. But it's a system that's very, very effective.
And the guy we just saw is the main man as well. He's the grandfather, really, isn't he? The godfather.
That's Ronaldo that's been around for the last 20 years. And he, whatever he says goes. Whatever he says, those fighters do what they're told on the mat.
So certainly, it's then as if old Yuricel has been feeding him one or two quarter pounders down the years. He's sure his body has seen better days, but when it comes to coaching judo players, there aren't many better than him. Fabulous character when he gets going. He's almost as entertaining as the players. Into the final 10 seconds of this match, and now Yannette Bomoy is heading into the third round.
And you can see the Cuban coach there just saying to Bomoy, just stay away, just stay away, just grip up, just don't do anything. Just let the time tick down. That's what she's doing.
She will have earned this victory on the back of two penalties handed out by Bogdanova. A couple of fouls leading to that Yuko score, and that's enough. And, well, you'd be well advised to steer clear of Lyudmila Bogdanova for the next couple of days. Yannette Bomoy, without really having to do too much.
No, but it's enough, isn't it? It's a tactical match, but she did what was needed. Couple of penalties, played it very tactically on the grips, got her attacks in before the Russian, and did enough.